Hey everyone. Okay, so today I'm going to do a little bit of video talking about some of the music production stuff that I do. I've been getting some questions over time on various videos when it does come to my music related stuff that people ask. Excuse me. So first off, you don't need to be super advanced with sound recording equipment and programs and things like that to start. Even, you know, years into the process of being a band or a professional musician or whatever, you really don't. There are a lot of great programs out there, whether it's Pro Tools, which my buddy uses for his studio for mastering and production and things like that. You know, Reaper and Logic Pro, and there's a bunch of other programs out there that are really great programs. But if you don't have a lot of money, you're on a tight budget and things like that, there are free programs that work just as well out there, namely like Audacity. And there's some other ones floating around out there too. They're solid programs and they work really well, and you can do a lot with them, whether you're just doing audio production for narrating stuff or as a musician and, you know, doing full song production and things like that. The other thing is, with various bits of equipment, you can go and get like digital interfaces, you know. So I use Focusrite Scarlett Solo. Largely I use this for vocal production stuff, but you can do what's called dry feed and plug your guitar right into a unit like this with a quarter inch cable, and then use VSTs or virtual amplifiers and programs and stuff on your computer to get the sound you want with various amps and things like that. That's one way to go. You can also just get a decent microphone, like a Blue Snowball, or other kinds of cardioid mics and things like that, for vocal production stuff. A lot of the time I'm using a Shure SM58. That is the workhorse microphone that's been in use for decades, I mean easily 40 years, as a primary vocal microphone for live production and sound production and things like that. It's a great microphone. It does not cost much. The Focusrite interface unit, the Scarlett Solo, I think is $100, and a Shure SM58 microphone is $100. Blue Snowball microphones don't even cost that much. They're like $60 to $80, and that's just a USB import. And what you can do with a microphone like a Blue Snowball, especially if it has a dynamic multi-setting, I think it's like setting one is for more vocal stuff, setting two is specific for the dynamic range and setting for instruments, and then setting three I think is more like ambient atmospheric, you know, just like surrounding noise and things like that. So like with that kind of microphone, like setting two, and then you can just mic an amplifier, a guitar amp that you already have, which is what I do for a lot of stuff. Several of my projects, my Bonnie Nordic Tribal stuff, I use that mic to I use the Blue Snowball mic to mic and capture all of the different traditional instruments that I use. My Odious Emesis Slamming Brutal Death Metal project, which I just had an album come out, that was all mic'd amp, like old school style, which is a background that I have, a little bit of experience with that, as a live sound engineer for venues and stuff, as a live sound guy and stagehand and everything. So I have some understanding of how to use a soundboard and how to balance and mix things. That base level of understanding from that application and that experience is very helpful for doing a hybridized kind of old school analog with digital interface, digital recording program and stuff, combination. It works really well, as you've heard, as you hear, you get really good sound still. And especially if you're using an even nicer microphone, if you can afford it, to mic an amplifier, you're going to get great sound. And I prefer Line 6 amplifiers. Usually the mid-range is pretty scooped. But that's okay. It sounds good, especially when you tweak the settings right and everything, you know. It's got the I use the Spider 4 and Spider 5 series amplifiers, both the live tour head and practice and like studio amplifiers and stuff. They work really well. I really like them for that. They have a great sound. They have great variety and options for if you want a lot of crunch and snarl with your distortion and stuff, or if you want to go clean, whatever, or something in between. Good options for that. Also, the Line 6 Helix board. I don't have one, but I've used one before, and I've got buddies that have that board, and that's a fantastic board because you can just keep programming more amp patches into it and stuff. And it's a lot like that on the digital side, on the computer and stuff with VSTs and stuff like that too. So you have a lot of good options out there, but you don't have to break the bank either starting out or even years into the game and getting it across at a professional level. It takes some time to adapt and learn and hone your skills when it comes to mixing and balancing and doing all that kind of stuff, you know. Everybody at the start, you know, it's not going to sound as good, you know, unless you really do take a lot of time and do a lot of studying, take some courses, really implement things that you see, like even on YouTube and stuff, because there's a lot of good material out there. But there is a broad adaptation level to get to a point where everything is sounding really good and how you want it to sound based on what you're using and what your goals are. So there's a lot there to play with, but that's just an example of some of the stuff that I use and some of the mindset and experience that I have and that I pull from and apply to how I do things. Even in some of my just like freestyle guitar jam videos and stuff, you know, if it's mixed and you're hearing drums and stuff, I mean, I do that all on Audacity. It's a free program. You need to take a little bit of time, understand how to, you know, maybe do double tracks and layers and then balance it out left, right, you know, and get your gain levels good and everything. You know, it all takes a little bit of time to learn, but after a while, you can do it no problem. And it goes for a lot of other stuff too, and same with vocal tracking and everything. Vocal tracking can be a little bit more difficult, but just because there is so much variation in the human voice and distance from the mic and things like that, because I prefer to hold a mic. I've got a mic stand here and stuff, but I just prefer to hold a mic. Again, live experience and just how I do it a lot of the time. But you do get some variation there, so then you have to go in, you know, if you're going to do compression, and then you have to go balance things and, you know, all that stuff. It takes time, but it's time for investment with music stuff. So, yeah, this is just some of the stuff that I wanted to kind of bring up when it comes to the audio production and options that you have that won't break the bank, that are very useful and functional bits of tools and equipment and things like that that you can use and get a completely professional level of production out of it with a little bit of time and effort and learning and adapting skills along the way. So yeah, that's just something I wanted to talk about with that kind of thing. Insofar as guitar stuff, I used to have quite a few guitars, but I've sold a lot of them. My primary guitar go-to is Jackson guitars. I use like EMG, like 81, 85, and 89, like HZ pickups and stuff, the fantastic pickups. I prefer 11, I play 6-string guitars. Gauge string, 11 gauge string, DR strings are my preferred thing. So, your high beams and your, like Black Beauties, so like your coated strings, also dragon skin strings, and then the DDT down tuned, series strings. I use them in 11 gauge, those different kinds of strings, all from DR strings, best performing strings I've ever used. They're all hand wound and just fantastic quality. Really good strings. So that's like the kind of stuff I'd use with that as far as instruments go. I have a bass guitar too, but I don't play that much bass. Sometimes I do, but, and that's a Ibanez Ergo series. But like with the Jacksons, like Dinky Body Jacksons, like, my main guitar that you see a lot in my videos, it's a DKM GT made in, I think, like 2001. Just fantastic guitar. Jacksons are my favorite, so, but yeah, that just some of the stuff with that. And then tuning-wise, I guess I should bring that up too. Tuning, I usually tune in C or C sharp. Sometimes I'll even go a step down from that, which you can do on six strings with the right gauge of string with it. But usually it's like C sharp for a lot of the stuff that I do. It's just a great tuning for that, you know. It's great for metalcore, great for black metal, great for death metal, you know, so. But yeah, I just wanted to go over some of that stuff and just kind of explain some of my rationale and mentality and process with how I do things. And again, give you some options to look at and consider for equipment without breaking the bank. If you want to get real, real high-end, you know, Sennheisers and get, you know, Pro Tools and all that, go for it, you know. Sky's the limit with that stuff. There's a lot of great microphones, tools, instruments, and all that out there, and programs and platforms. But if you are on a budget, or you want to keep things simple, or you're a little bit more old school and you're trying to kind of fuse new and old together and things like that, kind of like what I do, those are viable ways to go. And again, you don't have to break the bank with stuff. So yeah, that's pretty much it there. So if you have questions on this kind of stuff, you know, leave them in the comments. I may end up doing a second video about this kind of stuff, but that's a big chunk of how I do things and what I can offer with insight to people, either just starting out or, you know, they've been in the game for a while, but they're still, you know, questioning certain things or whatever, or they think it's too complicated or whatever it may be. No, don't make it more complicated for yourself than it has to be. You can keep it simple and still be extremely effective in what you do and being a professional. So, yeah, that's about it. So, thanks for tuning in on this one, guys. Metal up. Out.